Okay, I have a question for young Earth creationists. When talking about the Anisotropic Synchrony Convention, which I will attempt to explain in a little bit, why does Dr. Jason Lisle, which we see pictured right here, why does he get to make his own assumption, and a huge assumption at that, when he tries to figure out and come to terms with why there are galaxies billions of light years away, and there are also these vast distances in the universe that light has had to traverse? No matter what he finds, no matter what the evidence shows him, Dr. Lisle is committed to sticking to a 6,000-year-old universe. Why is that? Well, Jason Lisle works for Answers in Genesis, and one of the leaders of that organization and his boss, Ken Ham, insists that what he calls secular scientists can never rightly determine the age of the universe because all of their dating methods and measurements are based on failed human reasoning and assumptions mixed in with that human reasoning. Okay, and the problem I have, and every person who has ever visited Ken Ham's website should have with Dr. Lisle, is that he also makes one huge assumption, one that is staring everyone right in the face in interpreting the speed of light with regards to the Anisotropic Synchrony Convention. The bottom line is that Dr. Lisle and Answers in Genesis, they get to make assumptions, and vast ones at that, again, but they can't allow others in this so-called secular science camp to make any assumptions at all. They can't make assumptions at all. Okay, this does two things that are bad for astronomy and science as a whole. First, by displaying such arrogance and hypocrisy, Ken Ham and Dr. Lisle, in effect, brainwash their followers into thinking that there is something fatally flawed with every dating method in use today and with every way to measure billions of light year distances in the universe. There is not. This is dangerous thinking, not even remotely true, and fundamentally dishonest at the most basic level. You can't tell people that they should not listen to those other scientists. On the one hand, because they are pagan and they are secular, they make assumptions and their worldview is incorrect, therefore their science is not valid, while on the other hand, making incredibly wild assumptions as to the speed of light in a theory that may not ever be able to be tested, and then telling your adherents and your followers, that's okay, our worldview is correct, we can assume all we want. That is essentially what Dr. Jason Lisle is doing when he has to figure out the mental gymnastics to get around the deal-breaking reality that billion light-year distant galaxies actually had to exist billions of years ago for us to see them today. That's a fundamental reality, okay? Dr. Lisle uses the Anisotropic Synchrony Convention that calls into the question of that questions the round trip speed of light versus the one way speed of light. What Albert Einstein postulated that light could vary its speed in one direction and change it again on a return trip to a viewer as long as the round trip speed equaled c, which c is the speed of light. The Anisotropic Synchrony Convention is pretty complicated to explain, and we don't really have the time here to do it justice, but it does allow for varying speeds of light, in theory. And that, in theory, is big because there is no proof whatsoever that light can change its velocity at all. It is purely a suppositional theory that may not ever be able to be tested. There is, however, one team of Canadian scientists that claim to have tested the one-way speed of light and found no change in the speed at all. And I will link to that study in the video description below. But back to Jason Lisle. The problem Dr. Lisle creates in his wild assumption as to his use of the Anisotropic Synchrony Convention is that he picks the one and only speed of light that would make his assumptions work for a very young Earth and universe of nearly 6,000 years. Okay, either you can't make assumptions in science or any aspect of life, Dr. Lisle, or you can. Dr. Lisle's boss, Ken Ham, says in so much of the material that he puts out that secular science and all dating methods are based on assumptions and therefore they're not valid. But wait a minute. Is there not a difference in a reasonable assumption and a wild assumption? Is there not a difference between the reasonable assumption of, say, looking at a chair and thinking it is built well enough for you to sit in, and then the wild assumption that Dr. Lisle does or takes that may not ever be able to be tested and could have an infinite number of choices, and then he picks that one and only one choice that would make his mental gymnastics work. Okay, why is Dr. Lisle allowed to do that and yet on the other hand rail against the dating methods that are an absolute deal breaker for young Earth creationism? I'll let you young Earth creationists contemplate that for a while. You can read some of the source material that I talk about. I will link to that in the description below this video. Thank you for listening.